People often think that art and science are in conflict, and that's not true at all. One of the things that I really love about my images is it's a combination of the two. My name is Travis Rector, and I'm a professor of physics and astronomy here at the University of Alaska Anchorage. Like many Alaskans, I love to take pictures of our beautiful state. As an astronomer, I'm trying to share with people this exotic world of outer space, a place they will never get to visit, and similarly with Alaska, it's a place that many people will never get to visit as well. So in both cases, I use my pictures to try to share with people these places they may never get to see themselves. It seems like almost every day you have one of those special Alaska moments where you see something that you may never see anywhere else. It's been a lot of fun to share with friends and family from outside the state what it's like to live here. I've been fortunate over the years to have my astronomical images appear in many places. Been on the cover of National Geographic, have had images in the New York Times and other media outlets. One time I was on an airplane and the gentleman sitting next to me was reading a magazine and one of my images was there. And I said, "Hi, I made that image, that's mine." And he just looked at me like, "I don't believe you." And so that was the end of the conversation. Well, the first thing to know is everything you see in the images are real. All of these are pictures of real stars and galaxies and nebulae, but they don't show it the way that your eyes can see. They show it the way that our telescopes can see. One of the things that surprises many people is to learn that many of the nebulae that you see in these pictures are not too small to be seen with your eyes, they're actually too faint. So the colors in the images depend on what kinds of filters we use and what kinds of light we're looking at. And then what my images do is it translate what the telescope can see into something your eyes can see. The technology that goes into the camera on your cell phone is actually the same technology that was first developed for astronomers back in the 90s. And at the time that I joined Kitt Peak National Observatory in southern Arizona, one of the largest digital cameras ever built had been just commissioned for the 4-meter telescope there. And at the time we wanted to create some images to show other astronomers what the camera was capable of doing. And the images were so successful and so popular that we decided to start making more images for the public. And that was 20 years ago, and ever since then I've been doing that for Kitt Peak as well as other observatories, such as Gemini Observatory in Hawaii and in Chile. Often the universe is more exotic and amazing than what we can create in our own minds. And so the reality is often crazier than science fiction. These images are beautiful often, and it's exciting for me to put together an image and perhaps see an object in a way that no one's ever seen before. Sometimes when you create an image, you have a pretty good idea of what it's going to look like from the start, but often we don't. And what's exciting is to see what it looks like in the end. So it's absolutely a wonderful experience, and it's fun for me to be able to share this with other people.